Hi, I'm Courtney Rousel, 31, currently living in St. John's, Newfoundland. And as a lifestyle and fitness coach, it is my mission to empower people to become fit for life, to inspire them to become the person they once thought they never could be. With an unshakable belief in ourselves, truly anything is possible. But it first starts with a dream. So I'd like to take this opportunity to share mine. So I'm going to start off with a geography lesson. Newfoundland has a population of over 500,000 people, over half of which reside in the capital city of St. John's and surrounding area. The remainder of the province is consisted of small, rural, outport communities with funny names like Leading Tickles. Leading Tickles. Yep, that's right. That's where I grew up. Nestled on the northeast coast of Newfoundland, a population of 515 people. That's half of most major high schools, maybe even yours. So you say to yourself, what does this have to do with my audition? Well, you asked for challenges, and growing up in Leading Tickles, Newfoundland definitely had its challenges. I grew up sheltered, isolated, surrounded by the small town mentality, where my only exposure to the outside world was through the television screen. And I remember watching for the first time a fitness competition. I thought, wow, how amazing is that? I was captivated by their energy, strength, and beautiful physiques. I wanted nothing more than to be that girl. But it didn't take long for that small town mentality to creep in. What was I thinking? The nearest dance school was 6 hours away. Gymnastics was not a part of our phys ed program. And well, that girl, I'm sure she had parents that could afford the best instructors. She was special. She had something I didn't. Well, me, I was just Courtney Rousel from Leading Tickles. Skinny, non-athletic, better known as French fry legs to most of my peers. I really struggled to feel pretty. But that all changed when I went to university and discovered the dungeon. That's what, as students, we call the university gym. My first exercise was a leg extension, and from that moment on, I knew that the only thing in life I needed was a gym membership and a pair of sneakers. My love of training has carried me through many of life's challenges. Hitting rock bottom is something I know personally all too well. And on those hopeless gray days, I'd grab my gym bag, my favorite fitness magazines in tow, and I'd head to the gym for some emotional therapy. And as I flipped through the pages of my favorite magazines, I was inspired and motivated by the beautiful physiques that cover the pages. I'd escape into my dream world, only wishing that I could be her. Then reality would hit. As I closed the gym doors behind me, I would re-enter the drama that had become my life. My relentless determination to build that competitive physique had found me at the 2005 FAME World Expo in Toronto. I had moved there in pursuit of career goals. I remember the excitement, the enthusiasm. I was fired up inside as I watched my first figure competition. I thought to myself, hey, maybe I can do this. Maybe I can stand on this stage and compete. Once again, that small town mentality crept in. What was I thinking? I don't have a trainer, neither could I afford one at the time. Where am I going to get suits like that? I know nothing about contest dieting. And those shoes, how do they walk in those shoes? And I'm going to tell you right now, I'm still struggling with that one. Circumstances surrounding a failed relationship, unclear career path, and financial self-destruction had sent me packing back home to Newfoundland to rebuild my life. And there once again I found myself for more emotional therapy in the gym, training and training hard. I'd heard about a local figure competition. With the encouragement of my peers and my burning desire to compete, I stepped on stage for the first time, November 2006. I took the ladies' figure overall title. 6 months later, I competed again. Again, taking the provincial championship with the overall title, I had qualified for the Canadian national stage. And guess what? I decided to hit the stage again. June 2007, I placed 8th among 19 women across Canada. I stood on stage next to women whose beauty and confidence I had always admired from afar. I had become one of them. And how amazing was that to me? And as I reflect back on the last 2 years of competing, I realize it wasn't my love of training that got me to the competition stage. It was that childhood dream, fostered by my parents' voice. Courtney, remember, always believe that you can. It was that and the ability to visualize myself that one day I'd be on that stage. And hear the judges say, ladies, quarter turn to the right. Whether you believe you can or you believe you can't, you're absolutely right. And now, my dream continues to the Fame World stage this June. My reason for competing is different this time. It's not to prove to myself that I can, because I know that I can. It's to inspire all those women out there who still continue to dream as they flip through those fitness magazines, wishing nothing more than to be that girl. So I thank you for giving me this opportunity to share my story. I'm excited about auditioning for the amazing opportunities that you've created for the figure competitors. It is my passion, my high energy, confidence, animated personality that would make a great host, spokesperson, or featured athlete. And if I get selected for the comic book, I've got the perfect superhero name. So I'm ready to take this journey with you. I've got the body, now I'm